Good morning. Why did you leave these seats? For the special people? Okay. Before starting my speech, generally, this my brothers ask, tell me 3 sentences about you. I said, Arnold knows me. No, they insisted. We need 3 sentences. Before I start in my speeches, I generally say, I'm Dr. Ratnasiri Hewage. Because you know why? I mentioned this to last time also. I was on the road. That time I was the director of Lady Ridge Hospital, appearing most of the time in TV, in media. Then somebody is walking towards me, stopped at me. You just like Dr. Ratnasiri Hewage, director of Lady Ridge Hospital. Now only I realize you are not. No, it's real, Dr. Ratnasiri Hewage. Thank you very much, Arnold, for introducing me and the members of the panel. Very good morning to you. Good morning. What is the best find for a lecture? Which time? Morning? Just after lunch? No. What is the best time for a doctor? Arnold. What is the best time for a doctor? The best time for the doctor is now. For that matter, for any purpose, the best time is now, present. Second question from me. What is the best person in your life? What is the best person in your life? Who is the best person in your life? Person or people in front of you right now are the best people in our life. Third question, again from the chairperson. What is the best thing to do? This applies very well for doctors. What is the best thing to do in your life? Maybe as a doctor, maybe as a lover, or husband, wife. What is the best thing to do in your life? No guesses? No? If you can talk loud, just put your hand up, just to show that, you know, there's one person who knows the answer. What is the best thing to do in your life? If you don't remember anything in my lecture, please remember this. The best thing to do in your life is to care. If you become a doctor, the best thing to do in your life will become care. So best time of the life is the present. Okay. Forget about the past, forget about the future. It's person is the most important time. Best person is the patient who is in front of you. Not your wife, not your boyfriend, not your girlfriend, president, no. The person in front of you. Third thing is, what is the best thing to do? Care. Shall we tell it in together? Okay? What is the best time in your life? Now. Who is the best person in your life now? Person in front of you. What is the best thing to do in your life? To care, okay? Remember. So when we train doctors, engineers, drivers, everybody, we train them the science of doing that, and we train them the art of doing that. Science, for example, to drive a vehicle, we teach the science of driving. What is the vehicle is like, what is steering wheel, what is the gear handle, what is the clutch and everything. Those are the science of the thing. So then we teach them about the road rules, and we teach them how to drive, and we teach them, we put the elbow in front and the back, and we teach them how to drive. All those are the science of teaching, science of teaching. Then you can see some drivers, they can do gymnastic with those vehicles. They can go safari, they can challenge anything. They can challenge. So those people who do those gymnastics in their lives, they are the people who learn the art of doing things. So whatever you learn before this is science of treating people. You learn after your internship or during your internship and onwards is art of what? Art of what? No one is. They can't talk. How can we treat them then? Okay, art of what? Art of treating. Okay, we develop that art of caring. If you learn art of caring, you will become a good doctor. People remember you. You can remember Dr. Anthony, everybody supporting, he goes to the operation table and he starts operating. That's art of operating. So, all of you in front of me, like my own daughter. What I tell my daughter, you might get, say, pregnant without my knowledge. But still, I am the father of you. My heart is open for you. You can tell that to me. It is unconditional love. You have to give the patient unconditional love. To give the patient unconditional love, you have to learn the art of medicine. Art of medicine. So coming to my topic today, what is my topic today? Rational use of investigations. What is rational? What is the meaning of rational? Opposite of irrational. Very good. At least you can talk now. Because we are used to lecturers, professors, talking to them, and we sleep. Fortunately, professors do not sleep because they don't have what? Narcolepsy. So the rational use is the right test on the right patient at the right time performed accurately with interpreting commands. Got the point? The right patient. The right time. Perform accurately interpreting Kramen. So then comes the art thing. So you take history, whatever I mentioned in the slide. So that is what? You are taught, but not taught well. That is why, how many of you have sat for your existing? How many? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Three people only existing. Another, is this national our boy, Sri Lankan?
No, even the existing total.
Uh-huh. They were all. Okay, but three people. This is called paralysis. That's narcolepsy, this is called paralysis. Okay, so you have to learn the context, the experience, knowledge, everything to become a good doctor, to learn art of medicine. Then only we realize how to use lab tests rationally. So remember, when the patient comes, say patient come with a fever, one day fever, you write CRP, full blood count. What is the use of full blood count and the first day of fever? Useless. How many of you know the price of full blood count right now in the market? How many rupees? 500 rupees. What is the average income of a person per day? In US, the minimum is $8 per hour. I know that is not the case in Sri Lanka. Okay? So therefore, please try to use investigations rationally. Why I say so? If you take sample or population who we do our testing, these are the people who don't have disease. Okay? Good point? One nod in, okay, at least. These are the people who do have the disease. There's this yellow area. That yellow area is the false positives and false negatives. Okay? What will happen if you diagnose something false positively? Person who has no disease, no problem. What will happen? See consequences of this. This very latest, I got it from Journal of Preventive Medicine, June, Johns Hopkins University, American Journal of Preventive Medicine. They have studied, chairperson, 20 to 30% of ECGs, test results in false positive results. False positive. Remember, false positive I am talking about, not false negative. Because to diagnose myocardial infarction, ECG only one. Remember that. Only one criteria. Enzymes, history, and the ECG. ECG is one. So if you do unnecessary ECG, out of 100, you can find 20 to 30 people with abnormal ECGs. What happened? We can, and Dr. Arnold is a community consultant, community physician. I am consultant in medical administration. We can jolly well, criticize now clinicians. So cardiologist, so you find a false positive ECG, what you do? What you do? You refer that patient to cardiologist. You think that cardiologist will allow that person to go home? Go home? No. He will do all sort of, say, he or she will ask the person to do what? ECG again. Okay? Then, if it is normal, exercise ECG. Okay? Then, angiogram. Then you'll find 2 or 1 or 3 blocks in coronary arteries. Then you are given offer of bypass surgery. Some people can do that and some people can suffer that bypass suffering. Person was very, very, he was very happy before coming to you. You diagnose something. They worship you for doing karma to you. So you diagnose false positive ECG and now making this person mad. So remember, your decisions, your one word has consequences. Irrational use, why? They can do this, they will do, once recently, I discussed with Professor Ranjan Dias. He says, in a big hospital in Sri Lanka, they do sometimes in 5 CT scans in one person, one child. So in US, we are very, very happy because we don't do studies. We don't do studies. In US, defensive medicine counts for 1 in 5. Out of 5 CT scans, 1 was done to safeguard the doctor. Safeguard the doctor. Okay? The other thing, you are not, physicians, interns, are not aware of up-to-date recommendations. You think chest pain, if you won't do ECG in chest pain patient, you will get into problems. No. If you do unnecessary ECGs, say right-sided chest pain just here, and you can elicit the pain, okay, tender area is there, is reddish, everything is there, but still do you do ECG, and somebody will find some problem in that ECG. So make sure that you can go to the web. There are various organizations who have listed latest recommendations. Make sure that the patient who come to you doesn't know anything about that, but they worship you. They worship you. They thinking that you are doing the best thing for them is to do what? Care with love and compassion. Remember this. This is about doctors in, definitely not in Sri Lanka. Financial incentives. This is definitely not in Sri Lanka. Anil, because I want to go out. The GMOA members are there. Sri Lankan doctors, I don't know. So, but people might have suspicion if you do unnecessary testing. So we will be belong, well, this doctor belongs to this group. So that will damage our image. That will damage our image. Now still we ask, when the police stop our vehicle, I'm a doctor. Okay, doctor, we are sorry, you go. Still they do that. So it's up to you to preserve that. The other thing, this is very true, being a director of hospital, our chairperson knows how is the clutter in our medical records. We never retrieve medical records except in Sri Jayawardenepura General Hospital. Previous records, never ever. Because you can write, we never, administrators, we never question your decision, okay? We just let you do whatever you want. So in US, 1 in 5 CT scans are done just because they can't retrieve previous record. US, everything computerized. The hospital I worked before coming to this hospital, everything is computerized. One day, when I went there, they gave me a stapler and everything. I lost my stapler in 3 days. Then I tried to order stapler again in the Meditech, where the software is called Meditech, our software in that hospital. I tried to order, so you know, this holistic, total solution. Then they did not allow. They showed me, you have been issued stapler 3 days ago. But still, they cannot retrieve records. Those develop systems. Therefore, in US, now we mentioned one, this is second one, fifth. Okay? Now 2/5 of CT scans done in US. It's waste. And then we scold who? Barack Obama, Affordable Care Act. And these people who are not clinicians, they have some common sense. They have some common sense. He says, before the January 1st of 2014, you had to have computerized your office, doctor's offices. Now everybody has computerized because of this. We are not scolding, you are not blaming, you are not, you know, putting all the bad things to you, but it's up to you also to make these systems proper so that you retrieve the records and not do CT again. How many X-rays in one CT? Don't know. Okay. This is again, we don't do these calculations in Sri Lankan setup because we want to please our politicians, that we are the best, we have the best health system in Sri Lanka. Best health system. But in someone not the bad, not the worst health system, they spend the estimated cost of excessive lab and radiographic procedures $200 billion to $250 billion US dollars. $250 billion US dollars. I asked last year, Anil, I asked 7.5 million US dollars to build new building in Radiology. 7.5 to build 9-story extension to my the main building. $7.5 millions. Now this is 200 billion. How many millions in 1 billion? How many? 1,000. Okay? Remember that. When you marry and have your children, they will ask you, why we do this? Because we think according to nature, we speak according to the rules in medicine, okay? But we act according to the customs in medicine. We think according to nature, we speak according to rules, but we act according to the custom. It's up to you. Have a role when you finish your internship and go. I can remember when I became intern, I did exactly what my previous colleague told me to do. What to write? Fever? This is the list. Okay? Chest pain? This is the list. You know, you keep on doing that. This is his, Francis Bacon, very true, very correct. So, what are these customs? We do, when you go to hospital, you will see how many screens, torch screen, virus studies. When one consultant asked me to send those blood to UK and spend about, you know, almost million rupees to get this test done. Can you treat, can you cure if this results comes to you in time? She said, no. So you can't do, you can't do. So we are there to treat or care. We are there to care. Remember that, okay? So when you write torch screen, when you write serum chloride, you know, serum electrolytes, just remember, you know, when you go out of medical ward, collect numbers, how many serum electrolytes you found abnormal, how many chloride results you used for your decision making. Okay, this is one of little old slide I had. It's about the expenditure, how the lab and these investigations we are spending for capital money. Okay, it's going up and up and up. It's up to you, you know. We must thank GMOA because we get a, you know, reasonable salary of fighting. People scold us because of GMOA, because GMOA get, you know, scolded. They work for us and they do whatever they can, and we have to, but you need to have money in the treasury and the money in the Ministry of Health to do those things. Therefore, it's our duty to keep some money to get our salaries. So if you don't do that, this will happen. Okay, you have to put Ministry of Health into the ambulance and go. So health system objectives, don't think can increase the quality. It's the most important thing. Reduce cost, increase the quality, and improve the accessibility. If you write unnecessary testing, you reduce the accessibility, you increase the cost. Last slide. Got the message? Okay. Thank you very much.